Welcome back to Global Eye. We're discussing the India-China standoff, and I'm in conversation with Lieutenant General D.S. Souda, former Ambassador Vishnu Prakash, and strategic affairs expert Brahma Chalane. Brahma Chalane, if I can come to you, as Ambassador Prakash was pointing out before the break, that be it writing a letter to Indian MPs protesting about their participation in an event on Tibet or renaming places in Arunachal Pradesh, this follows a familiar script that we've been seeing over decades. But do you feel there is any immediate reason for this? Any intention that you see here immediately?
Well, China is waging a war of attrition, and the war of attrition extends to a hybrid war, which comprises what in Chinese doctrine is the three warfares doctrine. The three warfares being psychological warfare, legal warfare or lawfare, and information warfare. It is important for us to ask the question, why has China stepped up its three warfares against India? Have Indian actions been emboldening China? You mentioned at the beginning about India's gesture in exchanging sweets with enemy forces. Is that the only overture by India in recent weeks? No. Look at several other overtures by India in recent weeks. One was extending public support to the Beijing Winter Olympics, which have been dubbed the Genocide Games, through a joint statement with Russia and China. Then allowing space agency ISRO to enter into a commercial tie-up about its mobile messaging app with the Chinese manufacturer of mobile phones, OPPO. And most importantly, allowing the lopsided bilateral trade with China to jump nearly 50% last year. As a result, China's bilateral trade surplus with India now roughly is equivalent to India's total defense spending. At a time when China is waging aggression against India, India has allowed the bilateral trade surplus of China to jump so much that it's equivalent, almost equivalent or roughly equivalent to India's total defense spending. Now, all these things together are emboldening China. The exchange of sweets may jive with China's hybrid warfare. Now, that warfare is taking place below the threshold of armed conflict. But at a time when China has stepped up its hostile actions, it sent the wrong message from India's side. So I think it's very important to look at what India ought to be doing. India has the option of imposing calibrated trade and diplomatic sanctions to mount pressure on the PRC to vacate its land grabs in Ladakh and halt its frenzied militarization of the Himalayas. You know, what China is doing, it's creating war-fighting infrastructure on a frenetic scale, at a frenetic pace, and that infrastructure clearly indicates that either China intends at some opportune time to wage war against India or to keep India under sustained long-term military pressure. So we're looking at a very ominous future scenario. Of course, the third option could be that having achieved their territorial objectives, they intend to keep India under pressure through their three warfares doctrine. So whichever option China chooses, the
very
fact
important
is
points
that
there.
we're looking at a very different scenario in the coming years for India.
Okay, you're saying we're looking at an ominous sign ahead, but let me get in General Huda at this stage. General Huda, you've been hearing Mr. Chalane, and he listed out a host of areas where we could have put our foot down, and probably we sent a confusing signal to China as well. Now, how are we prepared right now when it comes to our border defences, border infrastructure, and what is probably lacking in our political and military toolkit? Because at the end of the day, your military policy, your defense policy is directed by the political regime of the day.
So, Prakshit, I think first let me just talk purely on the military front. I think there is a there has been a realization that we need to, up our military capability against China, which was a very welcome step. So you've seen a number of steps that have been taken. Infrastructure building has, got speeded up. At the same time, a large number of formations, which are actually troops deployed against the western border with Pakistan, have now got redeployed along the northern borders. So there is, as far as military capability building is concerned, there is, some enhancement of our ability along the line of actual control. But as, Mr. Chilani has pointed out, infrastructure development across the LAC in Tibet has also speeded up enormously in the last couple of years. And we are seeing, whatever shortfalls and weaknesses that that the PLA had, particularly in terms of air operations. We would always say that because they are operating from high-altitude airfields, they're not able to lift with full battle loads. They're going to have a problem. But they're working towards, improving those kind of capabilities. But as Mr. Mm-hmm. Chilani has also pointed out, and as you pointed out, ultimately, the military instrument is only one part of an overall strategy. And what is that overall strategy that we have, a long-term strategy as far as China is concerned? We know, militarily, defense budget, there is a huge gap. Economically, China is much stronger. As we look into the future, the gap will probably grow. And so what is our strategy economically, diplomatically, politically, militarily, to be able to deal with this China, which is going to be more aggressive, which is not only along the borders, but you will find increasing presence of the PLA Navy in the Indian Ocean. So we need to have some long-term thinking and a long-term strategy. And to me, that is something that appears to be sort of missing. So while we are fine to deal with day-to-day situations, but what ultimately is our strategy to deal with this neighbor, which is going to, as I said, become more aggressive and more assertive in the future.
Right. I'm going to put that final question to Ambassador Vishnu Prakash. Ambassador Vishnu Prakash, I could ask you about what's missing in the diplomatic toolkit. What are the things that the Ministry of External Affairs could do? But do you feel that at a political level, the goalposts need to be very clear? And once they are clear, we will be able to send a strong message to China as well. If I were to ask you, if India needs to set 3 or 4 clear goalposts when it comes to dealing with China, what would that be, sir?
Well, that's a very tough one because, A, we certainly do not want conflict. I would go to the extent of saying that even China does not want conflict, but certainly conflict is not in our interest. And effort and the reason for some reticence at some places is that you don't want to poke the dragon in the eye and you want to avoid conflict. Two, you want to bring about at least some peace, even if it's a cold peace, that is the effort. And three, you want to deal with China on terms that are not dictated by China, because their whole effort is to dictate terms. Now, the problem is that while we do have, the problem is that you cannot have a strategy written in stone because it has to be both proactive and reactive. We do have a kind of an approach, both medium term, short term, medium term, and long term. But one thing is not to poke China in the eye. The other is, on the other extreme, is to make gestures. I mean, I, for one, believe that China sees all these gestures as a weakness, whether it is sweets, whether it is just agreeing to join, to participate in the Winter Olympics. Why should we do that? So there has to be a diplomatic cost, but we need to stand firm on that. And about the trade, certainly the trade has increased. It has never been so high. Now, it is not possible to switch the sources or points of procurement overnight, but to allow it to balloon so much certainly is something that needs to be reviewed. So we have to follow slate of options, slate of measures. Some we have been doing successfully. Some we need to do a little more forcefully. I mean, that's the best I can say in the matter.
All right. Strong messages there from our panel, from Mr. Brahmachalani, Ambassador Vishnu Prakash, and General Huda, that sent clear signals. Do not show any weakness to China through your gestures as well, because this is a long-term game, a long-term negotiation that we are looking at, and there is not going to be any let-up in tensions or reduction in troops at the border anytime soon. Gentlemen, we've run out of time, but thank you very much for joining us here on Global Eye. We'd like to thank our viewers as well. Thank you very much for tuning in.